the practice of the Bhagavad Gita, day number 8. Today I have chosen the shloka, which is number 53 of the second Adhyaay, and I will chant it for you. Shruti vipratipannate yadasthasyati nishchala samadhava chala buddhi tadayogam avapsyasi. Translation: when your intellect, confused by hearing conflicting statements, will rest steady and undistracted in contemplation of God, you will then attain yoga, everlasting union with God. Bhagavan Krishna is explaining to Arjun, and through Arjun to us, the importance of keeping our intellect still, steady, and focused on our goal. As aspirants, we all want to reach our spiritual goal as fast as possible. And unfortunately and erroneously, we think that the more knowledge, the more information, the more sadhanas, the more difficult it all is for us, the higher we are going. Like we think we are, you know, like in school, in KG, we learn simple things, and then as we go to higher standards, 5th standard, 8th standard, 12th standard, our syllabus becomes more and more difficult. And so we think in spirituality also, we have to keep collecting more knowledge, more information, tougher sadhanas, tougher, you know, shastras, in the hope that we reach our goal right now, immediately. Actually, most of us don't even know what our goal is, and still we want to reach there. The thing is that every person is unique, and each person is on his own journey at different stages of their journey, with different levels of spiritual maturity, different readiness to absorb information. Some people have different goals which need different paths. So everything has to be done tailor-made for that person. There is no one thing that will work for everyone at a given point. Unfortunately, we are in an era where we have so much access to information on the internet, and anyone can post anything. And we are so hungry for information that we kind of just take whatever is available there, whether it is right or wrong, whether it is verified or not. There is only one authority that can verify the truth of spiritual knowledge, and that is the Vedas. Unfortunately, whatever is available on the internet is like a buffet table, you know. You can choose anything you want, and we choose everything. A little of this, a little of that, just like when we go for a buffet lunch. We take a little bit of this because it looks tempting. We take a little of this because it looks nice, and this because it's comfortable. This looks pleasant. In the bargain, our mind and our intellect gets totally confused. And that is what Bhagavan is telling Arjun, that when our intellect is confused by hearing conflicting statements, someone says, go and follow the path that takes you to Swarg. Do punya, earn punya, brownie points, you will go to Swarg. Someone says, forget about Swarg, go for Advait Vedant, blend with Brahma. Someone says that is blasphemous to blend with Brahma. So we just don't know what to do. And therefore we get spiritual indigestion. Mind anyway, its dharma is only sankalp vikalp. So you go for something, then the mind tells you to go for something else. This is the wrong way to approach the spiritual journey. What do we have to do? If we want to achieve our spiritual goal, we need to keep the intellect, as Bhagwan says, undistracted. And undistracted, doing what? Contemplation of God. And what will be the outcome of that? Bhagwan says, you will attain yoga. What do you mean by yoga? Union with Bhagwan. So here are 5 action steps to keep your intellect focused, crystal clear, and out of confusion of differing paths and differing sadhanas. First, stop spiritual window shopping. We go on the net and we do window shopping of spirituality. A little bit of this, a little bit of that. This is rajasic in nature. Contemplate, close your eyes, think of what goal you want. If you want a goal of swarg, stay with that. If you want a goal of moksha, stay with that. You want a goal of being 100% sattvic, stay with that. Don't keep jumbling up the goals. Fix your goal is the second step. Third, there are different paths if you want to just stay with swarg. If you want moksha, you have to go a little bit further beyond that path. So find an appropriate guru who can help you with the path and the goal that you have chosen. I remember when I met Swamiji, and the first question he asked me, when I asked him about spiritual goals, he asked me, what is your goal? Because I can take you either to swarg or I can take you to moksha. Where do you want to go? Because the paths will differ slightly. And so I told him, obviously, my goal was moksha. And so he took me down that path. So you need to find the guru who's appropriate to be able to take you down the appropriate path to the goal that you have chosen. Then follow the updesh of the guru. Keep the mind clear. Don't go on vacillating between this and that. That is rajasic in nature. And then have faith in yourself, have faith in the teachings, have faith in the guru, and keep going without worrying about when will I reach? Am I doing progress? Am I making headway? This is counterproductive. Because it will create vikshep in your mind. So, as we have discussed earlier, our right is only to work. That means our right is only to do purushart. When will I reach my goal? Will I reach my goal? What will happen when I reach my goal? What will I do after I reach my goal? This is not for us to contemplate on. Okay? Keep the mind focused on your goal. Keep the mind focused on your purushartha and let the universe take you where you deserve to go. More on the practice of Bhagavad Gita tomorrow.